On average, Australians are consuming somewhere between 30 to 50 teaspoons of total sugar a day. At least half of that, 15 to 25 teaspoons, being added sugars. The World Health Organization recommendations would be an upper limit of 9 teaspoons per day. We can see that the majority of Australians are consuming above the World Health Organization's recommendations for added sugar. Take, for example, a sugar sweetened drink. If you're consuming the 600ml bottle version of that, then you're consuming 15 teaspoons of sugar. Even if you go to the lower volume of the can, you're still consuming close to 10 teaspoons of sugar in that one serve. So you can see consumption of just one can of soft drink takes you to your maximum limit for the day of added sugar. The reason why added sugar is a big problem is because of its association with metabolic disorders including overweight and obesity, type 2 diabetes and poor oral health. And considering that we already have 2/3 of Australian adults overweight and obese, and 1 in 4 of our children overweight and obese, it's clear that it's now that we need to do something. Our food environment is saturated with foods and beverages that contain added sugars. In addition to that, there's an increased burden on the financial cost of the health system to the government. We're looking at increasing the price of products through taxation. We might also be looking at regulating availability and accessibility. That might mean restricting portion sizes in general stores, or it might mean restricting access, such as in school environments, where one might want to ensure that foods and drinks with added sugar are no longer available. A sugar tax is part of a solution, but it's not the only part. It needs to be considered in concert with things such as restrictions on advertising and marketing and accessibility and availability of these products. If there's one piece of advice that individuals could take on board to improve their current health status and prospects for later life, reducing added sugar intake would be it.